Algeciras, Spain, is a port city where the fishing boats leave early in the morning. Cargo ships unload containers from around the world, and locals sip coffee while staring out at the blue waters of the Bay of Gibraltar. If you're looking for a place to stay in Algeciras, it's hard to do better than the Hotel Reina Cristina. Since its opening in 1901, guests have included such luminaries as Charles de Gaulle and Orson Welles. They probably came here for the same reason Axis and Allied spies came during World War II: the unparalleled views of the Gibraltar Peninsula, a strategically valuable strip of land controlled by the British. It's 1943, and Larissa Swirski is a secret agent for the Nazis. Her assignment is to keep tabs on naval maneuvers around the Strait of Gibraltar, which the British are using to control ship traffic in and out of the Mediterranean. The intelligence she gathers will help the Nazis as they prepare an invasion plan for Gibraltar. Codename, Operation Felix. Before the war, Larissa worked in Paris as a photographer and palled around with the likes of Coco Chanel and Salvador Dali. Reportedly of royal Russian heritage, she hates the Soviets and communism with a passion. So when the USSR's enemy, Germany, tried to recruit Larissa, she said, "Sign me up." Allegedly unaware of the Nazis' nefarious activities throughout Europe, Spanish journalist Juan José Tellez says Larissa was among an assortment of spies stationed at the Reina Cristina in the 1940s.
Spies from the German intelligence service lived here, and British spies from Gibraltar came here pretending to have tea. That's why it was known as a spy route.
Here at the hotel, while Larissa is busy spying for the Nazis, British agents have their hands full monitoring agents like her for the Allies. According to the story, among those prowling the Reina Cristina for the British side is a young lieutenant and future James Bond author, Ian Fleming. His mission? To shadow Nazis and potential Spanish saboteurs in the event of an alliance between Spain and Germany. And one of the spies he's keeping an eye on is Larissa. As the war progresses, Larissa uses her skills as a photographer to gather an archive of reconnaissance photos, including potential aerial targets around Gibraltar. In 1943, Axis forces blow up a fuel tank in Gibraltar's harbor. The Germans are eager to find out the extent of the damage caused to their enemies, but the area is closely guarded by British soldiers. So they assign Larissa to go undercover and infiltrate the British stronghold. Liana Romero has heard the story firsthand from Larissa, who happens to be her mother.
She knew that was very risky what she was doing, because to be a spy, an agent, is very dangerous. But her ideas were not political, and also she didn't know what the Germans were doing really in Europe.
Larissa sneaks into Gibraltar's harbor, snaps the photo she needs, and then heads back toward the Spanish border. As she walks along the shore, a man approaches her and asks for a light. Larissa calmly pulls out her lighter, but it doesn't work. The man remarks, "I guess you Nazis didn't even leave enough fuel for a cigarette lighter."
At that moment, she realized that she was exposed, and she was in panic.
The British arrest Larissa and take her to their headquarters.
The British took her inside the room, ordered her to undress, and interrogated her for a long time.
Larissa plays innocent, knowing full well that if she confesses and the British get their hands on the small spy camera hidden inside one of her gloves, she'll likely be executed. But despite hours of interrogation, Larissa never cracks, and the British finally let her go. Shortly after, Larissa gets a visit from her sister, who's a member of the French Resistance. She clues Larissa in on the Nazi atrocities being perpetrated in other parts of Europe. The next day, Larissa goes straight to British authorities in Gibraltar and offers her services as a double agent.
Larissa Swirski's British code name was the Queen of Hearts. She went on to become a valuable double agent who was able to extract important information from the Nazis because they believed she worked exclusively for them.
And Larissa's point of contact at the Hotel Reina Cristina? Ian Fleming. It's widely believed that in his inaugural Bond thriller, Casino Royale, Fleming used Larissa as the model for femme fatale Vesper Lynd, the very first Bond girl.
My mother was very amused recognizing herself on the role of the Bond girls.
But Larissa inspired more than just the idea of the sexy female spy. During the war, she also gathered intelligence about Italian frogmen who stored torpedoes in the hull of their ship. With Larissa's intel, the British were able to stop their attacks. And if all of this sounds familiar, it's because Ian Fleming wrote about it in Thunderball. Today, there's considerably less spying going on inside the Hotel Reina Cristina. And with so much international trade at the nearby port, you're more likely to encounter shipping agents than double agents. But you don't have to be a spy to keep secrets, especially when those secrets involve torture and death. High on a hill in Slovakia looms the medieval castle of a serial killer who was so in love with herself, she'd do anything to hold on to her looks. And I do mean anything. The Slovakian countryside is covered with dense forests and snow-capped mountains. It's the kind of place you're almost not surprised to learn used to be part of Transylvania. Yes, that Transylvania. Nestled in a valley between the forest and the mountains is the village of Chaktice. And perched above town is the ruin of a castle straight out of a horror film. Chaktice Castle was built in the 13th century, when these lands belonged to the Kingdom of Hungary. It played host to the area's richest aristocrats, and one of those aristocrats ensured that it would live on in local lore forever. The year is 1580. Chaktice Castle is home to Countess Elizabeth Bathory. Few would guess that this cultured noblewoman is also a psychopath. Destined to become history's most prolific female serial killer.
Today, only one in six serial killers is a woman. No one knows how many there were in Elizabeth Bathory's time, but they had to be incredibly rare. Bathory was truly in a league of her own.
Slovakian lore holds that it was a single, seemingly innocuous moment that triggers Elizabeth's bloodlust. A servant brushes her hair too roughly, and the Countess flies into a rage. The slap draws blood that lands on her skin. Legend says that when Elizabeth rubs the blood away, she thinks her complexion suddenly looks more youthful. Thus begins her lifelong craving for more blood, to use as some sort of organic moisturizer. The bloody beauty satisfies her needs by luring young, unsuspecting village women to the castle with the promise of jobs. They have no idea they'll be murdered and drained of their blood. Ironic side note, the cellar that once served as Elizabeth's torture chamber in the Bathory Manor is now part of a winery.
Right now, we are in the Chaktice underground, and archaeologists unearthed some girls' skeletons here.
The Countess employed a staff of female torturers to do her bidding, which included lopping off victims' fingers with scissors, thrusting burning rods into their mouths, and ramming pins under their fingernails. Yikes, that seems excessive.